This meeting of the Somerset Board of Selectmen. Our first order is Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic of which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Amen.
Hey Scott, you should report the reorganization.
Yes. I'm going to announce that this meeting is being recorded. Is there anyone in attendance who is recording this evening?
I might be recording part of the meeting.
And your name?
Jen Andrew.
Thank you for the record. Okay. With that, we have had a reorganization of the board. As you are probably aware by now, I have taken the chair position. Mr. Moniz here to my left has taken the Board of Health, and Mr. Berrabee will be our clerk. So with that, we start our meeting. I will call for a motion to waive the reading of the Board of Selectmen minutes for the May 1st and May 6th meeting and approve as circulated.
So moved.
I will second that.
Mr. Chairman, I'm going to abstain from voting on these, seeing that I was not a selectman as of yet.
Yes, you will. And with that, Mr. Berrabee?
You will call aye.
And I will vote aye as well. Okay. Treasury warrants have been signed. Before we get to licenses, because we do have a minute or two, I am going to allow anyone to come up if they want really quickly. I know a lot of people are waiting to congratulate our newest member of the Board of Selectmen. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And I look forward to working with you.
Same here.
And I want you to know that your priorities as a board member will become this board's priorities.
Thank you very much.
Anxious to work with you and see what you can bring to the table. I know Mr. Setters has reached out to me to come to the microphone, if he will.
Steve, Selectman Moniz, I'd like to publicly congratulate you on winning this election for Selectman.
Thank you very much.
I truly wish you the best of luck, and I wish the town well as we move forward with our new Board of Selectmen. And I also would like to publicly thank the town of Somerset for the last 3 years for giving me the high honor of serving. It has been a distinct pleasure, and I think everybody ought to try it once. It's a fantastic thing, and the people have been gracious. And again, I thank you very, very much.
And if I may, Mr. Chair, I'd like to publicly congratulate Mr. Steve Moniz.
Oh, thank you very much, Mr. Mayor.
I know I did it in executive, but I want to publicly congratulate you on your hard work and bring it forth. Look forward to working with you as well.
Same here.
Well, seeing as well, we have a 6:05 appointment. I'm sorry, I'm going to have to hold the... I'm sure you're going to get a long line of people to the microphone, but they're going to have to wait a little while. If we get some time in the middle, we'll see if we can schedule that. Okay, our first order of business here. We have Mr. Ted Menzies. You were before us last week. We had some issues. I guess there was some issues with the fire recommendations for, I know if the chief wants to come up to the microphone also. I believe you met with our deputy fire chief.
Yes.
You have come into agreement as to all the things necessary. I see you have parking spaces outlined. You have fire access, which is significantly less than it was 2 weeks ago. Or everything is in agreement, Chief?
Yes. Deputy Chief Parkett went and met with the owner to review the initial requirements. There were some misunderstandings and some things that weren't clear. So I'm glad that he met with him again to clear those up. So we clarified all the requirements. The deputy made some amendments to some of the requirements. We're happy. He's happy. I don't have any issues with it moving forward.
Okay, I like to thank you for all your hard work in that, Chief, and Deputy Chief Paquette, who couldn't be here tonight. I know he had a conflict, so thank you for showing up. I also want to say it was nice to work, have the business owner and the fire department work together before there were any problems.
And that's our goal. You know, we're certainly here to be business friendly. Obviously, we can't turn our backs on fire codes and things like that, but we can work with businesses anytime we can.
Fantastic. Okay. Clem, what do I need to...
Do you have the amended...
I have the original in the blue folder. Where's the blue folder?
Joe Baldwin.
We're looking for that.
Okay. We don't have it. If you're going to incorporate the amended requirements of the fire marshal, then the vote should be to approve the change with those conditions incorporated. And do you have a copy of the amended one?
I do.
Does the board have a copy?
I will. Mm-hmm. Okay. I will call for...
You don't want the original ones, the ones that he just...
No, I got the May 11th revision. I will call for a motion to approve to Mr. Ted Mendes of Ted's Auto the expansion from 50 car license to 250 car license with the agreement that all stipulations spelled out in the May 11th, 2015 Fire Chief's and Paquette's, Deputy Chief Paquette's order as recommended.
So moved.
Second.
By roll call vote, Mr. Moniz?
Aye.
Mr. Barraby?
Aye.
And I will vote aye as well. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Ted.
Mr. Chair, we'll send up the paperwork when it arrives.
Okay. We have a myriad of one-day liquor licenses here. I'll give the board a moment to review them. Call for a motion to approve a one-day liquor license for the American Legion Post 228 on May 15, 2015, the hours of 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. at their Veterans Hall. I'll bunch all these together, make it a little easier. I will also call for a motion for May 13, 2015 for an Eamon Lyons fundraiser at the Progressive Club on Sunday, May 31st, 2015. I
read the wrong. I would have the Legion separate, and then you can bunch the ones that are for the Progressive Club.
Call for a motion just on the Legion one on May 15th.
So moved.
6 to 9.
Second.
All right, roll call vote. Mr. Moniz?
Aye.
Mr. Barraby?
Aye.
And I vote aye. All right, these next four, I believe.
Yeah.
For the Progressive Club, we have Sunday, May 31st, 2015, 12 noon to 6. For a outdoor beer garden to benefit Eamon Lyons. We have Saturday, June 20th, 2015, 12 noon to 4 for an outdoor beer garden for their own club members outing. We have Saturday, June 27th, 2015, 12 noon to 6 p.m. for a David Morey's Music Foundation outing. And a Sunday, August 23rd, 2015, from 12 noon to 6 p.m. for a Ride for a Child outdoor beer garden.
So moved.
Is Kevin here? Can we have a discussion?
We can.
Oh, Kevin, you are here.
Yeah. Okay. Come to the microphone, sir.
So you're basically adding another one, right? Eamon Lyons, which...
No, that was actually, we do it for a different family every year.
Okay, so this is usually the ones, you usually have four a year.
Yes.
Because I know we've had, some discussions with the neighbors.
Yeah.
Have they been informed of these dates as well? Can we maybe do that just for courtesy to them?
Sure.
So that they can make provisions?
Yeah, I can send a letter to... The
if you can, because I just think a couple of neighbors have already come to me, and they said, "Oh, have you heard anything?" Yeah, I'm like, "No," and here it is. But I'm just, You know me, I like to have a good time, and I like, you know, to, these events are great. We haven't had any problems, but I think out of a courtesy, if we could, you know, if you guys from the Progressive Club could send out a little notice to the surrounding neighbors, giving them the times and dates, just so they can make plans. They're going to know the band's outside. You're going to have the music.
Yeah, the only one that doesn't have a band is the members' outing.
Okay.
And that's just a gathering of the members of the club, no outside people. It's kind of like a private thing.
You don't have any music outside at all?
There's no music at all.
Okay, so, but...
That's the only one that you have each year that does not require a police detail. These other three will have a
police detail. The other three will have a police detail.
Okay. If you could just do that, and of course adhere to the times of when the music ends.
Sure.
Because you know them, they'll be right there at 6:05 or something.
Yeah, well, we got the bands pretty much ending at 5.
Okay,
and, great. And just to get everybody inside and cleaned up, we got it 6 o'clock.
I don't have any problems with it then.
Right. So we have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
All right, roll call vote. Mr. Moniz?
Aye.
Mr. Barabee?
Aye.
And I will vote aye as well.
Okay. I just had one request for you guys. For the safety of the motorcyclists, there's a couple of good-sized potholes between the club and Reed Street. Is there any chance
to... make them bigger?
Just fill them, maybe. Maybe fill them if that's possible.
Speed bumps.
You going for a swimming pool effect?
Well, I'm saying it might slow down the bikes.
They're actually they're pretty big. I mean, one takes up almost half the lane.
Mr. Brown, could you contact Brian Martin from the Highway Department and make him aware of those? Also, I know it's some time from now, but see if we can also send Brian Martin. I know we had an issue a few years back with someone. Excuse me. With someone... dumping a motorcycle over there because of sand. If you can coordinate with Brian Martin to make sure that that area is swept up prior to the bike run.
Terrific.
Great.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin. Keep up the good work. I'll be there anyway. I'll be doing these things.
I have public correspondence. We have one letter here from the Council on Aging Board of Selectmen. This letter is to inform you that there is a vacancy on the Council on Aging Board due to the death of Lee Goslin, whose term expires on June 30th, 2015. Very sadly missed. I believe I met Lee only once, and it left a lasting impression upon me. With that, we also have a letter here to at least discuss to the Somerset Board of Selectmen. I would like to be considered for the appointment to the open seat as a member of the Historical Commission. I have been a resident of Somerset for over 30 years. As a retired teacher, having taught in Providence for over 40 years and having volunteered my time to many organizations, I am on the board of St. Vincent de Paul Society for St. Patrick's Church, where I have also served as president. I am on the board for the St. Vincent de Paul store. Additionally, I volunteer at local soup kitchens, overnight homeless shelters, food banks, as well as summer camp for children with diabetes. And this is for Agnes Doyle. And this was submitted for us to appoint her to the open position on the Historical Commission. Is this something that can be done this evening, Mr. Brown? I'm sorry.
I believe it's on your agenda, so yes, it can. You did
no
have some feedback from the Historical Commission members last week, I believe. Yeah,
right.
It's on your agenda, so you may do that.
So with that, I will call for a motion to appoint Agnes T. Doyle to the vacated position of Richard Shane. This position will expire on June 30th, 2016.
So moved.
Second.
By roll call vote, Mr. Moniz?
Aye.
Mr. Barabee?
Aye.
And I will vote aye as well. Congratulations and thank you very much. I believe I saw her in the audience somewhere.
Oh, is she here?
Is she here?
I saw the sister. I don't know if I saw.
Is Agnes here?
Not.
No?
Okay. Well, I see the sister. I'm sorry. All right. Let's see. What time do we have? We have 6:15. Do we have our town moderator?
Lucia's
come on right up here, Lucia. You sit right behind the little computer module there that I can't see you from here.
Well, I'm so tall that it's really hard to find out where I am.
Well, Big in stature, though.
That's true.
All right. We have a town meeting next week. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
It's okay.
We'll share.
Thank you.
Okay.
Mr. Chair, anybody interested, the warrant, copies of the warrant for the special town meeting and annual are up here, along with the agenda for the meeting.
We have limited copies here. I don't know if there's enough for everyone, but feel free to come up and grab one. If you need any more, we can see if we can have them available at Town Hall tomorrow. I believe there's plenty of them there.
They're online as well, Dolores.
Correct.
They're also online. Sandy, was that you?
No
computer. Come on, get with the times.
I got no computer.
Joe.
No.
Okay. Madam Moderator?
Basically, I just need to know who's doing what articles. What I just passed to the Board of Selectmen and to the Town Administrator and Town Council was what is a consent article, because we have a little bit of a change from what we've done with consent articles in the past. So I will have copies available at town meeting for those people who will attend. Hopefully it's everybody here as well as many people watching.
Mr. Chair,
yes,
as
sir.
We go through, as Ms. Casey and I usually do, if there's any that requires something other than a majority vote, we'll note that.
Yep.
Okay. Lead the
I'll
way.
Wear high heels
you want to start
the next
with
time.
The annual special,
special town meeting.
Okay,
please.
Let's go.
Article 1.
Article 1.
It's a school department article, so I'm assuming that the school department will take that one.
Correct.
Article 2 is water pollution control. So I'm assuming water and sewer will take that.
Madam Moderator, I was at their meeting yesterday, and they did assign their 6 articles, so yes.
As well as the one for special town meeting, right?
Yes, including okay. The one, yes.
Thank you. Article 3 has to do with the award for the police and fire, I think.
Newly elected selectman want to take the first one?
Sure, I'll take that.
There you
that.
Go.
Sure. I have no problem standing up in that microphone.
Okay. That's because you're taller than I am. Annual town meeting.
Okay.
Article 1 has already been taken care of through the election. So Article 2, which will be a consent article, which is the traditional consent article. It just has a different format.
Mm-hmm.
Who would like that?
I will take Articles 1 through 6A, if the board pleases.
1 through 6A.
So that we're not getting up and down. I think we grouped them the last couple of times.
That's fine with me.
That's fine with me.
Mm-hmm.
So. And 6A is the budget.
Correct.
School department will take 6B and water 6C. Article 7 is a transfer of reserve funds.
Mr. Barraby, that's got your name on it, I think.
That's fine with me.
There you go.
Might as well.
Might as well stay up for 8 too.
Yep, I'll stay up there.
Article 9 is the regional school committee. Article 10, I don't know if anybody will be here from Diamond. I think the selectmen in the past have motioned that.
I will give a call to Marta and see if someone will be available, if she wants to present it. If not,
I'll do 10.
You want to take that?
You want to take 10?
10 and 11.
And 11.
Okay.
Article 12, to raise and transfer available funds.
That's
sewer.
Water and sewer. Mm-hmm. They're prepared to do 12 and 13.
12 and 13, okay. 14?
I will take 14 and 15 if the board pleases.
Mm-hmm. That's fine.
Sixteen is an assessor's article. But I don't know if they're going to take it or if the board is going
to
move it.
Again, I will reach out to the board of assessors. Yes.
I'm marking myself for presenting five articles.
Okay.
Okay.
So Article 16 is one, Michael?
16 through 20.
15, yeah, 16 through 20 is assessors.
Okay. Article 21. Clem, we're in agreement. That's a 4/5, and that's...
The next three are 21, 22.
22 and 23, and that's school. 24 is a school article. 25 is a school article. 26 is a school article. 27 is a school article. 28, 29, 30. 31 is a school article. Up to 32 on page 8.
Correct.
32 is the...
Dave, I think 32. I think 32 and 34 got your name on them, Dave.
Yeah, they did 32 and 34.
32 would be two-thirds vote because it's a sale of town land.
Correct. 33 is a petitioned article.
That would be the petitioner.
David, which one are you doing? 34 as well?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. Oh, yes, the 33.
Yeah. He said he would take that one.
Okay. Yep.
35.
I'll take that.
Where do you go, Steve? 35, Steve? 36 for yourself?
Yeah.
37.
That's water, sewer, too.
Yep, they're prepared to do 37 and 38.
Okay. 39.
I will do 39 and 40.
41,
it's the website.
I'll take 41. I might as well take 42.
You're going to do 42?
Mm-hmm. 41 or 42.
You're not going to do 42, John?
And that leaves...
CPA article?
Steve, you want 43 and 44?
John?
On the CPA article? Mr. O'Rourke may do it, I don't know.
Mr. O'Rourke is in England.
Oh, that's a problem.
Remote participation.
Well, that's really remote. I wouldn't.
What article are we on?
42. The CPA article.
Oh, the CPA.
Can we reach out to the CPA committee and see who we can get?
I guess we can.
Okay.
But Mr. O'Rourke is in England.
Mr. Rowe, we will contact other members of the CPA.
If not, I'll take it.
Yeah, I don't have a problem presenting
it. Put Dave down.
I'll take it.
All right.
Why don't I just take it? If somebody shows up, they can have it.
I'll check and let you know, David.
Okay. Thank you.
I'll do the last two.
There you go.
And the others are amendments to the bylaws. The zoning bylaws, so those
they're
are all
two-thirds.
They're all two-thirds,
Madam
correct.
Chair, the Planning Board is going to make its recommendation, as they're required to do. In terms of moving the article, I don't know if they're prepared to do that.
I know, that's been an issue before, where
and
they have not.
And they're the building inspectors, the first six are. The seventh one, I believe, is the Economic Development Committee, so maybe they'd want to move that. And then the last two are those, the privately petitioned ones, and I'm not sure about that. So we're going to have to confirm all those.
Okay.
I'm not sure the Planning Board is prepared to move those articles. They're going to make they have recommendations for
correct.
All of them.
Okay.
Finalize that and get that to you as soon as possible.
Thank you. That's it for me.
That was quick and easy.
Chairman, just a point of clarification.
Yes.
Since Ms. Casey is here, I've been asked from the American Legion.
Sure, please, yeah. If you will, Jameson, because the people at home can't hear.
Are you taller than me? Let's see. No.
It's close. I'm afraid of heights. Just a point of clarification, for the American Legion, for the sale of that property to the American Legion post, there was a discussion back and forth, an agreement that there would be a $10,000 credit that would come from the town to the American Legion. That is not on the warrant. So, you know, they're just curious on how to proceed from that. And, you know, Mrs. Casey's here, right here, as well. So, to kind of go over that, Mr. Chairman.
That was a oversight. As you know, we work on these for many weeks. I know Mr. Barraby here had met many times with your father and some of the Legion members. That was not relayed to us.
Right.
In a timely enough fashion, or it escaped one of us, I guess, at the point. Clem, how do we proceed with this?
I don't know what credit you're talking about. There were discussions about repairs that may need to be done, and that would be done after discussion among the Board of Selectmen if they use the fund that's available to the board, but I'm not familiar with any.
Yeah, and just to clarify, so the people know at home, the roof is in dire need of some repair. There's some holes in it. The American Legion has brought forward over the past 18 months or so that needed to be repaired, felt that we could, the Legion could repair it at a less of a rate.
Right.
I mean, without paying prevailing wage and everything. So by selling the property, then there would be a credit of a $10,000 for repair as needed.
There's no money appropriated for any credit. No, I don't think you could do that. The town can't repair a building it does not own. Now, if it's going to be done while the town owns it, the town has some funds that have already been appropriated. That would be part of the negotiation over the sale once the sale is approved by town meeting. So,
correct.
So it could be added, Clem, is what you're saying.
It could be discussed with the board. It'd be subject to the board taking a vote after.
Right.
So basically, and again, it wouldn't be an issue until we see whether it's even going to be approved for sale at town meeting.
Right.
So. Okay.
Are you good with that?
Yeah, no, I just wanted to kind of just, you know, because my father, he apologized he could not be here. He's up in Boston tonight with an event representing the Legion. So he asked me to be here just to represent him. And I was in discussion with Mr. Barraby, and I thank you very much for everything that you've done, Mr. Barraby, on this piece. And, you know, the vets do as well. But they're just concerned because the vote that was taken that night was with that caveat, so to speak,
right,
that either the roof would be repaired or there would be $10,000 going towards to repair the roof with the sale. So, you know, they're just concerned because of the language on the warrant there.
Right, because I did have a discussion. I mean, because I was away for such time and, you know, like you said, there was a little bit of lapse.
I think
and Mr. Setters is there.
Mr. Setters,
well,
if you can step to the microphone, please.
Yep.
David, at your request, I did speak with Steve while you were away on vacation about that, and we made it quite clear that that language would not be incorporated in the town warrant for this right here. That we'd be simply asking for permission to sell the property for a dollar to this veterans organization. And then sometime before we actually transfer legally, we would use money from the building maintenance fund to make improvements to the roof, most likely, for up to $10,000.
Right.
So that discussion will have to be at a selectmen's meeting after we see what the vote is.
Mm-hmm.
And it will be subject to a vote of the selectmen at a scheduled meeting with a posted topic.
Okay. Yeah.
So as long as the building, we can have a vote at town meeting.
Yeah.
Make that vote contingent upon a certain time frame. It can be the transfer of hands, you know, a certain date. And then we can, as the Board of Selectmen, approve the funding to repair something while it's still a town building.
Could I ask from the board just a consensus from the three of you if you would be in favor of something of that nature moving forward?
For the repairs to your roof?
Yeah, the repairs. Not to my roof.
To the American Legion. Strike that.
Yeah.
To the American Legion post's roof.
Yes. Yes, Mr. Monis.
I would be in favor of that. Using the monies from the $500,000.
Again, it's subject to a vote and a properly posted meeting. And even before that, it's subject to the town meeting vote.
Yes, absolutely.
You're getting a little ahead of yourself.
From us.
Well, no, yes. But you know what? It's but before, I mean...
Before it's consummated, you want to make sure that
absolutely,
it's,
before, yeah. I mean, if
all
the post is going
like, oh,
up there...
Oh, you got it from Dallas, see you later.
Says, yeah, we're willing to take it, and then all of a sudden,
yeah.
Something like this, you know, right. If the board's not supporting it
right.
Further beyond that point, then why would they support the first piece of it?
Right. No, right. This is fully supported. It was
yeah. Yeah.
Just an oversight.
Yep. Okay. Right. No, thank you very much for the
you're
clarification.
Thank you, Jameson.
Yeah, I think your question was, can we do something at town meeting underneath? No.
No, it wasn't underneath. It was just since you're here, if there was
right.
A language
yeah,
had it to be
it.
Added now. And
right.
I didn't think so.
No,
so.
Okay.
Yeah,
good,
you.
Jamie. We're on the same page. Anything else?
Madam Moderator,
see
is there
Monday.
Anything that we can do to expedite this meeting? As I know it's a concern of many that the meeting goes
be very concise when you're talking, and that will be very helpful.
Okay.
Stick to the point. Stick to the topic.
And everything's good for overlay of people if there's more than 800 people.
We're prepared.
Great.
All right.
Sounds good.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, are we doing anything that would require any sort of electronic media, any displays, anything like that at town
oh, yeah.
meeting?
We have one presentation coming through. I believe the regional school committee has contacted me with a presentation. So if anybody else is doing one, I have not been notified. And I don't think, Dolores, have you been notified?
Is there a deadline for notification?
Before Monday would be nice.
I'm just making, I don't know whether, I know Mr. Bennett on one of the zoning articles.
Yeah, he was at the planning board last night. He didn't have a audio, I mean, he had some handouts, but he didn't have an audio-video presentation.
Yeah, if it,
he was going to call you. I told him he needed to if he wanted to speak on that article.
It would need to be by Friday so that we can let SATV know what's going on so they can be prepared when a certain article comes up to focus the camera on the presentation.
Now, Madam Moderator, before we go too much further, I hope you stick around a little bit this evening. We have a new, just a few short minutes.
I'm not bowling tonight, but I can't stick around.
We have something new that I know Mr. Berube and myself, Mr. Berube, been leading the charge on this, a visual budget. Now, I know the meeting is slated to start at 6 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if this is something that could be done prior to the meeting, perhaps. I don't know how long it would take to demonstrate this to the public, David.
Not long at all. I mean, it's pretty easy
to use.
Well,
the appropriate time would be during discussion of the budget, I would think, at the meeting. I mean, otherwise
right.
People...
You want to do it during the... Well, I mean,
it's
separate, but it could be
I think it'd be good to do during the
budget.
Meeting. Yeah.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah.
So then
if it pertains to the line items in the budget and you're trying to explain something, that
right.
Would be part of discussion.
Well, this is also to guide people so that they're familiar with using it at home. This is something you're able to sit home.
Well, I think it could be used for both.
Right.
I mean, we can use it easily for this as a demonstration for the audience, which I think will be a good prop to have. But they'll be able to use it anytime they want after that as well. And they can even start using it after tonight, I believe. So,
all right, let me ask the point. Is it relative to the discussion of the meeting
the
or
budget.
Or what are you right, of the budget, or is it something that you're going to have an ongoing piece so that people understand? Because
this is more informational than it is would be for to inform on any one article, although the information there would help people make decisions at town meeting.
Mr. Chair.
That's why I said possibly before.
As Mr. Brown just pointed out, if it's just informational about how to get on it, you could do it before the meeting.
Right.
No, well, it's not about getting on it. It's actually about using the information
using
that's there.
But it's not particularly for the purpose of showing the budget for the discussion of the budget.
Not particularly. I mean, I guess we could make that determination after that is the next topic up for discussion.
Yeah, if we view
if
it.
If you want to view it and see where it could be, if it's before the meeting or during Article 6A or whatever article we want to put it in through.
If it's not discussion specific to the budget, it shouldn't be at
right.
That time.
Right.
If
that
it's
my
how
point.
To use the computer or whatever you have to get online to view other things, then no, that's not pertinent to the budget, even though that may be the topic you're using.
Right.
Well, let's just see. We're gonna
not only short, I just can't back up.
All right.
All right.
All right. Well. If you're still around when this is done, we'll have you back up.
No, I just backed up.
Can you skip to the next?
I can go to the next thing.
Skip around.
I checked this 3 times today.
Okay. It don't work.
Who's doing it to me?
All right. Our next topic for discussion is signed deeds for Marshan Street. Do we have those available?
Mr. Chair, I do have those. It'll take me a second. Yeah.
Marshan Street is a very small, it wasn't even a street, it was basically a 200-foot driveway. Two houses, it was a little hammerhead. Both houses have been sold. They were owned in the same family. They have been divided up, and it's right off County Street here. At a previous town meeting, we voted to... what's the term?
To discontinue the street, and then a separate vote was taken to authorize sale of the property. An appraisal was done by the assessors, and the figures were $2,600 and $3,000 as approved by town meeting. So I have the two deeds here. I also just gave Mr. Bolton the checks, which will have to be held in escrow until we deliver the deeds back tomorrow morning to the attorney. Attorney Frank represented the landowners. I need you folks to sign. We'll notarize this.
There are two separate deeds because essentially they took that portion of the street that the town discontinued and divided it. And it wasn't exactly half, but roughly half.
I will call for a motion to approve the quitclaim deed to Mr. Robert Ferreira for $3,000 for what was formerly known as Marshan Street, and Mr. Robert LeCompte for $2,600 for what was formerly known as Marshan Street.
So moved.
Second.
All right, roll call vote. Mr. Moniz?
Aye.
Mr. Barraby?
Aye.
And I will vote aye as well.
As soon as he said,
just got those in?
Yeah, these are the Ted's Auto Service.
Do we have all those liquor licenses? Do you sign those?
No. I don't know if he's got those. Joe, do you have the liquor licenses?
They should be in the blue.
They're in the...
Was handed up when...
They're in here.
Oh, they're all in that? Okay.
All right. Because we didn't have our blue folder, we have all these things to sign.
Dave.
Yes.
How are we making out, Bonnie?
Okay, I'm on the internet.
Would it be helpful to lower the lights a little bit? Would it be helpful to lower the lights a little bit? Thank you. Listen. Whoa.
That's really low.
That's not lowering the lights.
Joe, while you're doing that, you want me to give a little overview of what this is? Is that okay? The last MMA meeting that actually Scott and I attended up in Boston, which was a very good seminar convention, one of the items that really kind of stuck to us was the fact that Arlington Visual Budget, I forgot the gentleman's name, Adam, he actually was involved.
Alan Jones?
Nope. No, Adam, it's Adam. Adam, whatever. But he's now the TA for Arlington.
Adam Champlain.
Champlain, yes. Thank you.
Champlain. He came from Fall River.
Yeah, I came from Fall River. Designed this program to give the Arlington residents a visual budget. And we were really impressed with this because, you know, we talk about the promotional stuff or the informational packets with the pie chart that we'd send out, which is just a pie at the end of the warrant that we tried to send out, which was $3,500 per mailing. We looked into this, and this cost the town $3,000. It's a one-time fee. They're going to give us technical support 2 years?
Two or three years.
That included everything you're going to see here, which basically is a program that's really easy to use, shows you revenues, expenses, funds, and reserves. I'm going to let, you know, Joe take over because he knows exactly more about it. But
the lights down,
no, I think that's good. Can everybody see?
Everybody see?
So this, I'm going to turn it over to Joe, but this is basically the webpage that you're going to come on when you get onto the link, which is SomersetVisualBudget.org. And Joe, why don't you take it away?
Sure. Really, the main purpose of this software is to answer questions like this. You put in your tax bill, how much you paid for your taxes. You can put any number in here. And with that, you can answer questions like, how much does it of my tax bill goes to pay for the fire department, or the schools, or snow and ice? So that's basically how it does it. And it does it in graph forms. So let's just get out of here. So we'll start with the expenses.
Internet's a little slow here.
Yep. Okay, so here is fiscal 15, which you can select any year, right here. We also have fiscal 16 projected budgets up here already. And we've got it divided into major areas of government: education, town and elementary schools, insurance, public safety, public works, state charges, general government, culture and recreation, long-term debt. And right here, you can see the relative sizes of the different areas in government. So for example, if you wanted to see, you go into general government, you click that, and now it brings up each individual department in general government. So for example, you could take, the assessors of your $2,000 tax bill, $4.77 goes to run the tax assessor's office. Their budget is $120,000. You can drill down even further into the assessors, and you have personnel services of $113,000, and down here, I can't even see the number, but it's 27 cents of your $2,000 tax bill goes to the expense budget for the assessors. And here you have a chart of graphs over the years. Again, the light blue is the payroll, the dark blue would be the expenses, and the trend. You can see the total, what it was compared to from last year, the average over the last several years, what this budget's been, the percent of total expenses, and then you can take it and you can actually slide it and see what it was several years ago if you want. That's one way of doing it, or you can go back over here and select a different year. So again, you just go back. Again, go back. The school budget's right here.
I can't even see those numbers.
All right, so we have the school department has personnel services of your $2,000 tax bill. $492.92 goes to personnel services for the elementary schools. Over here, $234 of your bill goes. Somerset Berkeley, $305, and $54 for Diamond. Bristol Aggie was so small, you couldn't even see it up on the map. But again, you can, you know, this is the year, 2013, and you can just bring it over this way if you want. And you can see this is where the regional school started. It went up and it came down a little bit, and this is the graphs. If you wanted to look at an individual budget, say personnel services for the school, this is just the graph for that segment of the budget. So it's pretty easy to run. I mean, it has all kinds of flexibility. The other thing you can do, go back a little bit here. You can look and it gives you, well, that's not a good example. It gives you over here, you can click and you can see each one without hovering over them, what the expenses of each budget. For example, public safety is 9.13 expenses of the total budgets of the town, whereas compared to 15.58 for the schools. General government, and this is all of general government, all those departments, it's only 3.65 percent of your tax bill is going to them. So we can look at long-term debt, same way. We've got principal and interest. These are the amounts. And then you just scroll over it. And then it basically shows you, you know, $39.23. You can also look at it in a map view, the tabular view. And it basically gives it in just a different format. So we'll go back to map view. Same thing goes, so these are just, you know, these areas of government are not arbitrary. These are pretty much what UMass accounting standards and the state Schedule A format use. This is the standard layout and where we look at government. So even culture and recreation, you can drill down into that one. That one has more than a few departments, but you've got libraries, which is $19.76 versus, if you go into all the way into libraries, you can see it's $4.87 in expenses to run this facility all year. And again, you have the trend, you can see what's been going on. You can pretty see that their expenses have tracked down slightly over the last few years. So it's a pretty useful tool. You can really, I mean, even down to the smallest American Legion, we're talking about American Legion, 10 cents of your $2,000 tax bill goes to them every year.
This was 2013, John?
This is 2015 up here.
Yeah.
You know, some of this has been rounded to the nearest, most of it's been rounded to the nearest thousand, just from a practical standpoint. So again, you know, you can get into every single department is laid out here somewhere. And again, you know, you have the total segment graph, or again, go into veterans benefits. Now you have just the graph over here for veterans benefits. You can see that, you know, it's been climbing a little bit. But again, $307,000 is $1,223, or $1.90 for expenses. You want to see what it was, you know, a few years ago. It's $12.02. Go all the way back. It was $8.23. So it has a lot of flexibility. That pretty much covers the expenses. We go to the revenues. Reload?
Ah, that's the story of our life. No revenues.
What did you touch? Yeah, try reload. Yeah, try go back. Let's see.
Who said that? Internet connection.
No! Let's see what. It's like the high. It's everybody's got their cell phones on, right? Put them on airport. Air.
Hog in space, huh?
They're hog in space. Airport mode. For those of you that, I hear somebody saying they don't have a computer. I know why. Now I know why. You can come to the library and we can set it up on one of ours for you if it works. I'm trying.
Okay, Bonnie. You know what? They don't want to waste all night on this, but
I'm not even getting up.
You're
so subtle.
Pass it by.
Anybody have a hotspot on their phone?
Yeah. Yeah.
Pass on that question.
Yes, Madam Moderator.
My suggestion would be not to do this
anymore. Yeah!
Only in my reasoning is this is more of an educational tool that needs to get out there, so I would suggest to the Board of Selectmen that they separate, that they bring it to meetings, take it to each precinct, however you want to do it. But if you want actual access of this by our residents, then I think it needs to be done separately where people can ask questions and not just have it going.
Is this something that we could schedule perhaps maybe at 4:30 or 5 o'clock before the meeting?
Are we doing it?
And have anybody ask any questions beforehand?
But as long as you have, I mean, you can do it, but you need somebody to be there to be running it and to be.
And it's not going to be me.
It's a long night. I would rather see you do this at another time and kind of let it go or start it up and make it important, like advertise it and do it, because there is a lot of good information on there. I know Joe didn't do the moderator's salary because it would probably be a negative number. But I think if it were done separately, it would be much more effective and a much better tool for people to use. I think doing it on the same night as town meeting where people already have a purpose for going is going to defeat your purpose of bringing it to the people.
Well, I think the whole point of doing this tonight would be this is going to be available online tomorrow, that people can look at it between tomorrow and next Monday night, so they can get, you know, informed before they go to town meeting. We're going to have a link on the town's webpage, and the direct address is just simple somersetvisualbudget.org. You go right in there. The password screen will be removed tomorrow, so anybody can have total access to it. So, I mean, that was the intention, to get a demonstration tonight so that people could start looking at it this week.
Correct.
Over the week.
Correct.
And it puts the budget, in relative terms.
Right.
What I was going to say is the revenues are broken down in a similar fashion between real estate, personal property, licenses, permits, all the revenue categories going back, you know, several years.
Excuse me.
There's a lot of small talk.
A lot of small talk. Can we keep it to a minimum, please? Thank you.
I think it's the computer and not the...
All right. I think we have a pretty good idea of that. Thank you, Joe.
Now everybody needs to vote for the library budget. No.
There you go. I do want to make one last remark. And the folks at Visual Budget were very nice, very accommodating. I worked with Annie LaCourt and Alan Johnson, and they couldn't have been more helpful. We are, I think, the third community in the state to go live, if not the fourth. So, you know, we are at the forefront of budget presentation using this type of model. So,
and I'd also like to point out, Joe, I know you've been doing a lot of work on this, as has Dave. The reason why this has come right now is because we went to this meeting in late January, contacted this company. I believe this board signed the document only about 2 months ago. It took a while to get it up and running. As you can see, it's not just fiscal year 15-16 we put in there, but we went back a number of years. It's very easy to navigate. It's very easy. The modules upload themselves straight from our cherry sheets, am I correct?
Or from our accounting software.
Right. So it's not something that costs us any more to do in the future. It automatically comes right out of it. As soon as he's putting it in his computer, it's actually updating in real time on the visual budget. So,
you give up.
I'll take citizens.
Sorry.
And if I may, Mr. Chair, I like to thank Mr. Bolton for taking this on. I know he was also doing the duties as the acting town administrator, and he worked with them to get this up. And like I said, within 2 months, we got this up and running. And like I said, if you have a better, faster internet service at home, because I've used it, and it's really pretty simple. I might look a little complicated, but actually, it's real easy to use. And I think if anybody's concerned about the budget or where your money goes, like, you didn't get to show you the revenue side, because the revenue side kind of goes like this and plummets, and it's projected to plummet. So it really will give you a nice reference as to exactly how much everything is in relation to, you know, your overall tax, not just an average of a home that's $237,000, a person paying $3,500 in taxes or whatever. If you pay more, you pay less. It's all relative to your situation, which really makes it even more important. So
that's right. You can put in your exact.
You put your exact. Look at your tax bill. If it's $5,500, you put that in there, and bingo, everything is calculated on $5,500.
The computers, the computers in the library are hardwired and are faster. I am working reference Saturday, so if anyone wants to come in that doesn't have a computer and wants to look, I'll walk you through it. Come in on Saturday. I'm in there 10 to 3. So.
And once again, it's Somerset.
It will work.
It's pretty simple to just remember SVB, not a SUV, but SVB, SomersetVisualBudget.org, and you're on.
All right. We can have the lights again. Thank you. All right. Thank you very much for that. Let's see. That's going to be very helpful. I think we'll be driving around town and seeing blue lights late at night from people's computer screens as they're... adding in their information. Let's see, we have to appoint the town administrator, Richard Brown, as the board's representative to the school department negotiating committees. This is Mr. Brown. Mr. Clem Brown.
Attorney Brown.
I got Sandy Brown, I got Clem Brown, I got Richard Brown. We got more Brown in here than UPS.
We've heard that one before.
Going down. Yes. What do we do? I don't have anything to sign.
Statutorily, the selectmen have a place on the school committee negotiating team. The tradition has been,
either as a member of the board or as their designee. The tradition for many years has been the town administrator, who is the general government bargaining agent, is the designee for that committee.
Now, this here says school committees. Is this implying that this is both regional and K through 8?
Yes.
So I will call for a motion to appoint Richard Brown as the board's representative to the K through 8 and Somerset Berkeley Regional High School's School Department Negotiating Committee.
So moved.
Second.
By roll call vote, Mr. Moniz.
Aye.
Mr. Barabee.
Aye.
And I will vote aye as well. Along the same line, we have to make a motion to appoint Richard Brown to the Somerset Health Group Executive Committee.
So moved.
Second.
By roll call vote, Mr. Moniz.
Aye.
Mr. Barabee.
Aye.
And I will vote aye as well. Appointment of fence viewer. What do we have on this? I don't know if it's Joe or if Mr. Brown has anything on this, because we have nothing in our packet on it.
Currently, the fence viewer is a highway superintendent.
Correct.
The building commissioner expressed interest in doing it from a practical standpoint. Right now, it goes to the building department, then it has to go to the highway department, then it has to go back to the building department. He's willing to take that on to simplify and this process so that it speeds it up. I spoke to both parties. They were in agreement. The superintendent is more than willing to give that up, and the building commissioner is more than willing to take it on. There's no compensation, but it will streamline the fence permitting process a great deal.
With that, we will appoint.
Motion.
I will.
Mr. Chairman,
yes.
Mr. Bolton, could you please explain to the folks in the audience and those that may be watching what exactly a fence viewer does?
Well, I mean, I have limited knowledge of it, but my understanding is that when somebody pulls a permit to put a fence in, there are certain setbacks that have to be made. For example, I know the better facing side has to go away from your property. So this person will go out and see where they're going to put the fence, make sure it's not too high for guidelines, and basically give it the town's blessing, if you will.
Okay.
So I don't think it's much more than that.
All right. With that, I'll call for a motion to appoint Paul Boucher.
You have a question in the back.
Can you come to the microphone, please, sir?
Jack Tulin, River Village. If I may, well, Mr. Bolton, but that's an unwritten rule. Mm-hmm. You can put your fence anytime you want. I surveyed for 40 years. You can put your fence on any side you want. And that's the way it is. Westport has a surveyor, a fence surveyor, just to be sure it's maintained on the right line.
I see.
Point is, it doesn't have to be on the property line. Of course, it has to be. Most people, for 100 years, have put 1 to 2 feet back of your property line so you can do maintenance in case you have a squabble with your neighbor. If I may, I'm sorry.
Thank you for that clarification. Yeah.
Thank
He's
you.
An accountant anyway.
All right. I will call for a motion to appoint Paul Boucher as the Somerset fence viewer.
So moved.
Second.
By roll call vote, Mr. Moniz.
Aye.
Mr. Barabee.
Aye.
And I vote aye as well. All right. We have already taken care of the Somerset Historical Commission. Board of Health, discuss joint nurses position and sign agreement if ready. I'll let you go on that, Mr. Brown.
Mr. Chair, as you can report, the screening committee interviewed candidates for the joint nurse position, and I believe we'll have a recommendation for next week's meeting of your Board of Health, which Mr. Moniz is now the chairman of, and for the Swansea Board of Health, which I believe meets on Monday. As we've discussed in the past, in addition to hiring the nurse and reaching agreement with whoever that might be, there has to be a joint agreement for the shared nurse program. That agreement was drafted about a month and a half ago and agreed upon, except we have a blank for the figures for the our share of salary and expenses. Salary is set, but expenses are going to depend on who the person is and what health plans they take, life insurance, etc. We have all the figures from Swansea. We just are not ready to plug them in, but that should be ready at the same time as your vote next week. So
correct.
I'll let you take it from there.
Yes, we interviewed four candidates for the position of town nurse. It was myself acting as Board of Health Chair for Somerset. It was Jim Cavallo acting as Board of Health Chair for the town of Swansea. Yeah. And it was also Joe Cavallo, who is our inspector between both towns. This position falls under health inspector domain. So the board met. We interviewed four candidates. We have submitted to our boards of health a recommendation mm-hmm. for town nurse. We will receive that as a Board of Health recommendation next Wednesday. Swansea will be receiving that for their Board of Health on Monday, and their Board of Selectmen, because this is a inter-town agreement between two towns, that's handled by the Boards of Selectmen. So we will take a vote on that next week as both a Board of Health and a Board of Selectmen to sign the agreements. And we are in discussions with this person now to see on a starting date, but it looks as if it'll be perhaps July 1 at the latest, but it could be mid-June, depending on how much time this person needs to give their current employer. So we will have a joint position between the two communities. It's a significant savings for both communities, and I think it really allowed us to go out and get somebody that we would not have been able to get had we have been looking for a part-time nurse. Part-time positions are sometimes difficult to fill, and with the qualifications necessary, we were able to share all the costs associated with this, and we have what I believe to be a spectacular candidate, and someone who is looking forward to serving the community and actually increasing awareness, doing things like health clinics, vaccinations, making herself more available nights and weekends, certain times of the year. So it's really encouraging. I think it's going to be a great thing for both towns. So that's the update on that. Next up, we have sign a certificate of recognition for Crop Hunger Walk Day on May 30th, 2015, and I will read. Town of Somerset, Mass. Crop Hunger Walk Day. We sign this annually. Whereas the end of World War II, many people wanted to share our country's abundance with European war victims, and church, world services, and crops' first purpose was to gather wheat and other crops from U.S. farms for shipment to Europe. And whereas today, locally organized church, world service-sponsored crop hunger walks are an important part of community life for more than 2,000 towns and cities in the United States, bringing together people of different faiths, diverse cultures, and all age groups. And whereas Crop Hunger Walks have raised over $200 million to bring help and hope to people in need around the world and in the U.S., and whereas each year Crop Hunger Walks help more than 3,200 local food pantries, food banks, and meal sites in the United States, providing food to neighbors in need, including Delmon Hageman Pantry at Church of Our Savior in Somerset, Mass. And whereas the annual Crop Hunger Walk will be held on Saturday, May 30th, 2015, to help our community become aware of and concerned about hunger and its causes. And whereas, I haven't used so many whereases in one document, whereas the Crop Hunger Walk will raise funds to help stop hunger both locally and globally. Now, therefore, we, the Board of Selectmen of the Town of Somerset, Mass., do hereby proclaim May 30th, 2015, as Crop Hunger Walk Day in Somerset, and do urge the citizens of Somerset to support this Crop Hunger Walk. I will call for a motion to sign this declaration.
So moved.
Second.
By roll call vote, Mr. Moniz.
Aye.
Mr. Barraby.
Aye.
And I vote aye. All right. Next up, we have a point. Yes.
Oh, no, I'm just saying. Did we do that one?
Yes, we did.
Mm-hmm. We did?
Yes, we did. Okay. Appoint special counsel if ready. That is not ready, as it is not necessary. Casino update. We have nothing new to report at this point in time.
Can we talk about that a little bit, though?
We could, if you wish.
I like to, because with Don Setters not being on the board anymore, I would be willing to be the go-to person for the casino proposal.
You are more than welcome to be the point person on that. I know ordinarily we schedule phone conference calls, but I know during the week and such that there are many calls that go on. We will pass that information on to our consultants, and you can relay that back through the board.
Is it possible to have a little discussion with Mr. Monas as to his... I've never had a discussion with Mr. Monas, but I'm just concerned. I'm not concerned. I'm just wondering where your stance is on an industry or some type of a business that may come into town that's going to provide thousands of jobs for the community and millions of dollars of tax revenue.
Please.
There's really not much to discuss. I mean, what I've said publicly throughout my campaign, I will continue to say, I am not a supporter of that idea. I believe something else should be looked at for that parcel of land. And until you come up with something to present to the board with more information, it's a no for me.
So. Okay, but I just want to get... I just want to make it clear. So this is just a personal... your personal opinion. So you're not willing to bring this forth to the citizens of the town. You want to take the stance that you're looking out for the town's best interests. No, I'm asking a question.
Excuse me. Now, understand. All right, understand. This is not a debate segment. What you are witnessing here today is an executive board meeting. I'm sorry, if you speak up again, I'm going to have to ask you to leave. You're watching an executive meeting. If you wish to speak, you can come to the microphone. We have on the back of our sheets, and I will have these made up in a larger format for anybody who does not have them. It makes the meeting much longer if people just talk out of place. People at home can't hear you. We can hear you up here. At home, it just sounds like a cacophony. If you come up to the microphone, everybody can hear it. We want to restore some order to these meetings and make them so that people can enjoy coming, be informed, and leave here without feeling like they've been ridiculed. So going forward, please remain that.
Okay. May I continue?
Please.
So I'm just, like I said, you know, Mr. Monas, I'm just trying to find out where your stance is, because the previous board, with having Mr. Setters on the board, was that we were just... And I want to make this clear that we are just entertaining the possibility of having a business, an industry, that could come to this town, and they haven't made a proposal. That's why we really don't have anything in writing. But it's still an option that's out there, and I just want to know where you personally stand, because if you're saying that you personally don't agree with this, that's fine, but I don't think that you have the right or you have the position that you shouldn't allow the townspeople to make that decision on this matter. That's all I'm saying. Because I'm going to give him time. I just want to know, there's either, like I said, you can be not for it, but willing to... I'm not grandstanding. I'm not grandstanding. I'm just saying that we should bring this proposal, if it comes to fruition, if it actually comes, that we should be able to bring this to the citizens of this town and let them decide. Please, I'm not asking for any input. I'm just telling you that we're working on this. And we have been working on this. And we have consultants that have been working on this. We have very prominent and diligent people who are working. We have a feasibility study that's allowed for anyone to see. I'm just saying, Mr. Monas, I just want to know if you personally and morally are against this, or are you willing to at least present it to the citizens of this town and let them decide, or you don't even want it to go that far?
The citizens of this town, once there is a proposal and there's some concrete information in which they can make an educated decision, will have the ultimate decision. We'll have the ultimate say.
So you support that?
The citizens can do that, absolutely.
No, I'm asking you.
The citizens, that's, Mr. Berube, that's the process in which you have to follow. I'm telling you that I'm not for the casino. I've said that my whole campaign. I don't believe it's a good fit. I don't know how much more I can put that out to you. I don't know what you want me to say that's going to change my mind.
No,
the citizens, I let you speak. The citizens will have the ultimate decision to make once the process is followed. My stance is I don't think it's a good fit for this community. You have obviously the opposite stance, and this is how I feel. And this is, you know, this is where I'm coming from, and you know that, so.
Well, no,
what?
I
yes,
didn't.
You do know that.
No, I don't. All I'm saying is that I'm willing, and I'm not saying if they want to come in and they want to do something that doesn't fit the community, I'm not saying I'd be for that, because I don't even know what that is yet. But I'm saying I'm keeping an open mind to see exactly what they are going to propose, is what I'm saying. And I'm giving them that option, but you're just saying that you're not giving them that option at all.
I never said that.
Okay. All right.
Mr.
All right. I think we know each person's stance here. We're not going to settle anything here.
This diffuse
the
situation, I mean.
There's nothing to diffuse.
I'm sorry. This may be all for naught. So at this point right here, we're going to move on. We'll have anybody up under citizens' input in a couple of minutes, please. All right. Topics not reasonably anticipated by the chair 48 hours in advance of the meeting. Do we have anything this evening, Mr. Brown?
Which one?
No.
Which one?
Either one.
No.
Either one.
Mr. is Brown. There we go. All right. And do we have anything, fellow board members?
Under other?
Mm-hmm. Under topics not reasonably anticipated?
No, I'm other.
Okay. I don't have anything.
Old routine business task updates. It's difficult to have task updates when we've had a town administrator only in the office for 3 days. But do you have anything that you're willing to share with us as far as an update? Mr. Flanagan, please.
Just that I'm being inundated with information. I'm trying to be responsive, so understand that, and I will, if people are trying to contact me directly, I will get back to you.
Thank you. All right. Do we have anything under other?
Mr.
Yes, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you going to say something?
No, you can go.
Okay. I just want to remind people that there's a road race, the May 16th. I think it's sponsored by the PTO organizations to raise funds for the technical support field or technology field or technology classrooms. I'm going to be running in that race, and I challenge all public safety employees. Actually, I challenge all town employees to participate in that race by either walking or running. It's a Saturday, May 16th. It's to support our school system. So, I have some other commitments early in the morning. I'm going to be there running. I'm sure Mr. Austin will be there right alongside me. So come out and support our schools. It's for a good cause.
And I will join you in spirit. As you know me, with 5Ks, I usually like to sprint them.
Okay.
No, actually, it's my anniversary on Sunday, so I will be away. So
congratulations.
Thank you. But I will be there in spirit, and I do fully, wholly support it, and I would recommend any and all people to show up. I don't have within any packet or anything like that, any information as where the... George, do you have anything on that? I know it was in the paper. I perused right over it. I'm sorry.
It's going to start at Pierce Beach. I believe it's going to start at Pierce Beach.
Yeah,
and
Pierce
the
Beach
race course is going to be down Riverside Avenue of some sort.
Fantastic. All right.
And I have other.
Okay. Mr. Barraby?
I just would like to... I don't think I thanked anyone for the letters and the texts and the Facebook messages of my wedding and such. I didn't publicly do that. So I want to thank everybody for sending me that and wishing us well with my my new wife. And the other thing I'd like to say, too, is that I'm really glad that the board moved the meetings here, because if this was at the town hall, this meeting here would quite not make it. So I'm glad we're here. And the last thing is, there's a bike and car show at the Stop and Shop, and it's a fundraiser for the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. And I'll be there with some music, donating my services. And if you get a chance to stop by, It's a fundraiser. I'm not sure how they're making money, but if you can make a donation, make a donation. But
when is that?
This Saturday. I'm sorry. It's the 16th. Yeah, this Saturday. But it's at one to four. So we'll be doing the race and then heading over there. And
I have one other, and it has to deal with our town clerk, Dolores. I want to thank you personally, and as a board, I think we can agree that Monday's election went off fantastic. I, for one, was familiar with going to the one voting polling center, as I'm from a town that had that years ago. I know there are little bugs that can probably be worked out, but I think for the first time out, you did a fantastic job, you and all your employees.
I agree.
And I do want to commend you. I know going forward, it'll even be easier once we get new parking spots and everybody's familiar with it. And so I do want to commend you on that and thank you for all your hard work in setting that up and making sure it went as well as it did.
Thank you.
Thanks, Laurie. Okay, now is time for citizens' input. Mr. Pacheco?
Yes, Virgil Pacheco.
Are you running?
I will probably walk if you walk.
You could probably still beat me.
So Virgil Pacheco, 31 Forge Road. A couple comments and, you know, general statements. Dave, I actually have to say I'm very disappointed in the comments and the attack that you just took on Mr. Moniz. I mean,
it's not an attack.
It's an attack. It's an attack, okay? You guys came together today as a new board, right? There was should have been a spirit of cooperation. You guys started out the meeting by saying that. And to publicly try to pinpoint Mr. Moniz was uncalled for. I mean, that was totally uncalled for. There are a million people in this room right now that have differences of opinion, whether they're pro-casino or not. This board has not come forth with any information regarding a casino except for no info. No one knows what the agreement is between the attorney, what their fees will be.
That's
no
public
one,
document. Hold on. That's public document.
It doesn't
that
matter.
Was signed
it doesn't matter. But you, everyone kind of focuses on casino. Think of one thing. This town for years has basically put all their eggs in one basket. Mm-hmm. Right?
Two baskets.
You are, two baskets, but in a sense, one industry. Mm-hmm. You're essentially taking the eggs from that basket and trying to put them into another. All right, you have no plan B if this gets voted down at public meeting. You have no plan B if it gets voted down by the commission. And you have no plan B if the developer comes in with no funding. You have basically wasted a year plus with the town's time.
I will stop you there. Come on.
Scott, oops. Go ahead.
That's somewhat inaccurate.
Okay.
There are other things that we are working on that we cannot divulge.
Okay, Scott. I'll let you finish.
I'm sorry. This is, and perhaps, but the reality is, when you're working with, now you should know this, I believe you were with CVS or something for a number of years, a lot of companies do not come into an open meeting and say, hey, we're thinking about opening up here in town. We have an economic development committee that has worked tirelessly. I believe you're on it.
Scott, I am on it.
Right.
And I recall about 6 months ago that there were directions to hold on all development pending the casino. Including
that,
the Wilbur School, including the Wilbur School
site.
And the Route 6.
On that one
Wilbur
site.
Wilbur School and the Route 6.
And we are because currently working
ancillary,
on a number of sites.
Scott, again, my comments are, it's very unprofessional for this board in public session to attack another board member. Point blank. It's like you officially attacking, you know, an employee of the town. So that's uncalled for. And then two,
it wasn't an attack.
Two, your opinions versus the casino may differ from Mr. Moniz's. Doesn't make you right, doesn't make him wrong.
I'm not saying
okay,
he's right or wrong.
As far as the voters are concerned, they have not made any public opinion on it because they don't have any information.
Well, some of the voters have
They have no information.
I know.
They have no information. I deal with development every day, okay? I used to work at Bank of America. I deal with construction. I'm a construction manager. You do not go down one avenue with one purchase and sales at a time. Your Mr. Setters is a real estate agent. He doesn't advise his clients to accept one offer at a time or just solicit one offer at a time. You go to multiple. So I just wanted to, I mean, I'm surprised at you, Dave, because I mean, I thought you were a respectable businessman. And I like you, but that was uncalled for.
Okay, thank you.
Totally uncalled
for.
I want to clear the record, if I may. I apologize. I'm apologizing publicly. I did not.
But Dave, you should have done that behind closed doors.
You can't do that behind closed doors.
You could have talked to him behind closed doors and asked him his opinion. This is uncalled for.
I figured I'd be transparent and I'd be open.
Dave,
I just want to.
Dave, you see, Dave.
I'm just saying.
Cat calling from the audience, please. It's not appropriate We're up here answering any questions you have. Next week, there will be a police officer here. If it continues again, we will have people removed.
Mr. Sutters.
Yes.
I mean, Mr. Sutters. Mr. LeBeau, may I?
Yes.
Please. Ladies and gentlemen, I appreciate all your support, and I appreciate your tenacity and your stances on the issues. But I would have to agree with the chairman. Please keep the comments down so that everyone in the audience has the opportunity to come to the podium and voice their concern or address the board. If that will happen, then things would run a little smoother, and then we can get on with our meeting, especially with the citizens' input, because I know many folks like this portion of the agenda where this board, the chairman, gives you the opportunity to come to the podium. So please, I would ask, I would follow the chairman's advice. Please let folks come to the podium uninterrupted. No heckling, no cackling. Let them make their statement, and then this board can address it.
Thank you. Mr. Toulin, if you can come up to the microphone again, please.
Thank you. Jack Toulin, Whitney Village. I've been elected member of the planning board going, starting my ninth year about 2 days ago. And Mr. Barabee, I want to direct this to you. No matter who I want on the planning board, I never vocally or put signs on my property for other people. So how can you have a good board when you, on your property you own, you put signs for other people? That's impossible. I'm sorry. That's a wrong thing to do. You may have your rights, but you don't do that in public if you're on the board. How does this man accept you, or how do you accept him when he knows who you voted for? That's a wrong thing,
and
that's
what I'm telling you.
Yeah,
that is my opinion. And I'm 67 years in this town. 67 years is a lot longer than you've been in this town. And that's a wrong thing to do.
If I may.
That's it.
All I want to say to that is, at least once again, I was open as to who I thought was the best candidate to be in this position. I'm not saying Mr. Motis isn't going to do a good job. I never said that. Well, you know what? You guys can have your own opinion, and I'm just telling you what I did, and at least I had enough guts to do what I feel. Some of you people put two or three signs, so what does that mean?
I'm for any sign but one.
Well, that's fine, and that's your opinion. And I'm going to do what I feel is right. I'm willing to work with Mr. Moniz totally, and you'll see that.
Unified board, sir. How does that make a unified board if you publicly before the election put a sign in your
People
property?
Endorse people all the time.
Excuse me. No,
I'm sorry. That's enough. Mr. Toulin, that's enough now.
If I may just finish this. You will see that I will work very well with Mr. Moniz, and if he has any issues with me, he'll take them up with me, just like I'll take them up with him. But I don't have any problems. I will be working well with Mr. Moniz.
I'm sure you will.
Okay. We have Mr. Viveris.
Yes.
Are we going to keep this nice?
I'm going to be nice.
Let's end on a high note
this
here.
This is Viveris, 3096 Riverside Ave. All right, so obviously everybody has their opinions. Okay? These three men are still elected officials. They need to work together. I'm sure they're going to work out their differences, because if not, then us as the people will take care of it when it's our time to do so. Until then, let these guys do their job. We've voiced our opinions. People have been heckling people. We still have to have mutual respect for everybody. Everyone should have a right to talk and say and be respectful of each other. The heckling don't do nothing. Come on, this isn't high school. We're all residents. Everybody has valid points. But do them the proper way. I wish you all the best. You have a lot to do.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you, Mr. Viveris.
Sandy Brown.
Three-eighths County Street, Mr. Brown. Listen, I'm going to suggest something to the board tonight. You guys represent the town. You do the negotiations for all the townspeople, right? Now, before you give any raises, I would like to see the board come back and let the townspeople vote on that there before you give the town away. Because, what do you call them, just got a big raise, the school teachers, right? The cops, the firemen. Where's the money coming from? The town's broke. Come on, they gotta have some say in this thing here.
The townspeople have the ultimate say at town meeting next Monday.
Of all this thing here that went in with the state and all that, well, then the townspeople should vote them down, period. No raises for the next 5 years. Because if not, this town here is going to be owned by the state in 3 years.
Thank you, Mr. Brown.
Okay.
Well said.
All right. With that, citizens' input is done.
Not you, Mr. Mullins.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Mullins. I didn't even see you there.
All right. Jim Mullins, I'm in 71 Prospect Street. I've got a question. I'm a little bit rusty on my legalese. I'm a former union official. But the question is, when the A&F committee does not recommend an article, does that mean that there was no more debate allowed on that article?
No.
Or can it be modified?
Absolutely not. It can be any article could be modified, and that's just that board's opinion with the information that was presented to them at that time that they didn't recommend.
Okay. So at the time that this article is brought up that was not recommended from the body, we could submit another figure on that same article?
The town moderator has said in the past that she will usually limit the amount that can be changed by a percentage depending upon what she feels is appropriate.
If it goes
okay.
up.
But the debate does not yeah. stop.
Yeah.
May I, Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Mr. Mullins, when the articles come before town meeting, town floor, there's always a discussion. And that's when the citizens can either choose to make a motion to amend the article, or as long as it's okay with the town moderator. Obviously, she conducts the town meeting. But there's always a discussion concerning an article. As Mr. LeBeau said, that is just a recommendation from the Advisory and Finance Committee.
Okay, thank you. I intend to be at the meeting, but I may be delayed because that night, fortunately, is the same night that I have to go to BCC and present the Mullins Family Nursing Scholarship, which I do every year.
Oh. We'll save a seat for you. Okay, with that, I have a few reminders. We have, on May 18th, we have a special annual town meeting, 6 p.m., vitally important. It's 6 p.m. The polls, I believe Dolores has said she'll be opening the doors around 5:30? 5:15. So you can get there early, get a good seat. We have the Memorial Day Parade on May 25th. That's at 10 a.m. Always a good time. Please show up. And May 25th is also, I believe that date is wrong there.
Yeah, I think so, too.
May 25th.
Yeah. May 25th is Memorial Day, and town offices will be closed that day. So with that, I will call for a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
By roll call vote, Mr. Moniz.
Aye.
Mr. Barraby.
Aye.
And I will vote aye as well. Thank you, and have a good evening.
Thank you. All.